Once upon a time, there was an orchestra, which was all busy tuning up. First, the oboe gave his aid to the strings, then to the woodwinds, and to the brass. Up and around the scales, they raced helter-skelter, faster and faster. All but Tubby the Tuba. He was a fat little tuba, puffing away, but oh, so slow.
Oh, what lovely music, thought Tubby, and he sighed.
Here, what's the matter, said Peepo the Piccolo.
Oh, said Tubby, every time we do a new piece, you all get such pretty melodies to play. And I never, never a pretty melody.
But people never write pretty melodies for tubas. It just isn't done.
Shh, there's the conductor. First the violins danced their lovely little tune on their strings. Then they cry to the flute, catch.
Got it, cry the flute.
My turn, tooted the trumpet. And the rest joined in. The cello. Then the oboe. And the bassoon. Tubby went, pop, 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 pop.
Catch me, cried the little tune, catch me.
I got you, cried Tubby.
Oh, you're sitting on me, said the little tune.
Poor Tubby picked up the flat little tune and tried to squeeze it back into shape. You clumsy fool, snapped the violins.
I'm sorry, Mr. Fiddle, said Tubby.
Fiddle? Fiddle indeed! And the violins quivered with great indignation. You will please address us as violins. Fiddles indeed! Tubby, said the conductor. Tubby, what is the matter?
Please, sir, I thought it would be so nice to dance with a pretty little tune instead of just going oompa oompa all the time.
Dance, laughed the violins. Dance? Well, really. The French horn quietly put his hand to his mouth and smiled, and the whole orchestra began to laugh. Stop it, cried the conductor. Stop it, I say. Tubby.
Please, sir, I wasn't laughing.
Rehearsal was over. Tubby was walking home with Peepo the Piccolo.
Please, Peepo, said Tubby. I just feel so bad. I don't think I want any company.
I understand, said Peepo. Good night.
Good night, said Tubby.
The moon was out, and Tubby went to the river and sat on a log, and he looked at himself in the water.
Alone am I, me and I together. If I went away from me, how unhappy I would be. Me and I, oh my.
The trees whispered in the wind, and the waterfalls tinkled. Suddenly, a big bullfrog hopped out of the water and sat down on a log beside him. Lovely evening.
I said, lovely evening. I said, beautiful evening. Hello. Hello. Hello.
But Tubby just sat.
Oh, well, said the frog. Oh, well, if I'm not wanted.
Oh, cried Tubby, please, Mr. Frog, come back. I didn't mean to be impolite.
Back hopped the frog.
Oh, that's all right. I'm used to it. No one pays any attention to me either.
Really? Said Tubby.
Why, of course. Every night I sit here and sing my heart out. But does anyone listen?
Oh, no. Can you sing? Asked Tubby.
Can I sing? Listen.
Oh, that's lovely, said Tubby.
You try it, said the frog.
Oh, thank you, said Tubby.
Say, you're a very fine tuba, do you know it? Tubby, you should try that on your orchestra sometime.
Oh, I will, said Tubby. Goodbye, Mr. Frog. And off went Tubby, as happy could be.
Hmm, said the frog. Most appreciative audience I've ever had. Fine musician, that tuba. Good night.
The next day, the orchestra was busy tuning up for the rehearsal and buzzing with excitement over the arrival of the great new conductor, Signor Pizzicato. Here he comes, called the French horn. Here comes Signor Pizzicato.
All right, gentlemen, let us begin.
And Tubby began to play his own little melody.
Oh, that wretched tuba snapped the violins. He'll disgrace us. The trombone stuck out his tongue. And the trumpet snickered.
Tubby, said Signor Pizzicato. Tubby, I've never heard a tuba play a melody before. Would you play the rest of it?
Oh, said Tubby.
Why, how perfectly wonderful, said the strings. Please, Tubby, may we sing your tune, too? How about me, said the xylophone. And me, said the trombone. May I, said the celeste.
Here I come, said Peepo.
And they all play.
We've done it, haven't we, Tubby?
It was the bullfrog sitting right beside him.
Oh, thought Tubby, how happy I am.